अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर स्टूडेंट स्टूडेंट एज वी ऑल नो दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी कम्प्लीटेड द इंटायर पोइट्री सेशन ऑल द एक्टिविटीज विच एवर इज देयर इन योर सिलेबस एज वेल एज द टॉपिक यू कैन से विच इज ओमिटेड आई हैव ऑलरेडी हाईलाइटेड यू इन द पोइट्री सेशन एज वेल एज इन द प्रोज सेशन द टॉपिक विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वेरी वेरी दैट इज कंपल्सरीली आस्क्ड इन द बोर्ड एग्जाम इज appreciation of the poem appreciation of any poem from your syllabus okay now here that means question number 3b your section 2 that is poetry it's of 14 marks 10 marks is for the activity solution scene extract and question number 3b will be the appreciation of the poem any poem they will going to ask in the paper so you have to be thoroughly prepared for it and you have to know how to write we will learn how to write appreciation of the poem okay so what is poetic appreciation student we know that appreciation means to you can say recognize or enjoy the good qualities of someone or something okay poetic appreciation that means is the attitude about poetry is the attitude about the poetry that means here we will going to see about that what things what poetic device poet has used in the poem what kind of a language poet has used in the poem how you can say about the title poem and the poem whatever is highlighted in the poem you have to write you can say appreciation of the poem that means poetic appreciation is that attitude about the poetry that means you will going to recognize and as well as enjoy the good qualities you can say a good moral lesson which poet will going which you can say through the which poet wants to give through his poem clear now student question number 3b as I said will be the compulsory question from the procession okay so here question will be asked in this type with the help of the following point write a poetic appreciation of the poem here I have chosen the poetry that is 2.6 father returning home okay father returning home your page number textbook page number 160 student it is not compulsory that points will be given to you it is not compulsory that points will be given to you it is for your convenience just for the sake of learning that how we will compose how we will going to write a poetic appreciation so these are the points which you need to highlight while writing poetic appreciation of the poem student there are two types of writing poetic appreciation you can write in a para wise but the points which I have given you everything you need to highlight for it is my advice or it my suggestion for you that whatever in your paper when you're going to write a poetic appreciation of the poem so what you will going to do highlight each and every point because as we know that examiner has so many paper to assess they will not going to read the whole paragraph the thing is that if you want to make your paper presentable if you want to gain good marks so according to the point wise try to write the poetic appreciation of the poem and it is of 4 marks clear each and every point I said I will repeat my words again that points it is not compulsory that the following points will be given to you you need to remember that these are the point which I need to highlight in the poetic appreciation of any poem and I said I have chosen father returning home that is page number 160 okay your text 2.5 now student I have already explained you in my lectures in my previous lectures about this poem father returning home now first point about the poem poet and the title you have to write now father returning home first of all you need to remember that who is the you can say speak poet of this poem is a narrative poem of the poet Dilip Chitre and this poem is taken from traveling in the cage most important point what you need to remember father returning home is a poem written by Dilip Chitre and it can be asked student that which type of a poem it is it can be asked in you can say in an activity solution that which type of poem is this is narrative poem okay in this poem poet depicts the dull, monotonous, exhausting and equally pitiable daily routine of his own father. Student dull, you know, monotonous means boring, tedious, exhausting and equally pitiable daily routine of his father. In this poem, the poet has drawn a pen picture of his aged father in two different situations. In the train, while returning home from work and at home. Student, this poem, it is a monologue. It is a monologue. Student, monologue means speaker. In monologue, speaker is the only person who is narrating the entire, you can say, entire happening. Okay, about his life. About his, here, therefore, this poem, it's a monologue. Why it is a monologue? Because it deals with the suffering of a man who is isolated from the society that he builds. Okay. The poet's father in this poem reaches the prime of his age. Okay. He has reached to his age. But still work hard to earn his livelihood. And when he travels back home in the late evening, where he, there he is not welcomed warmly by his family member. So that means in this poem, poet has highlighted the suffering of a man, the plight of an aged father, his own father. Okay, and you can say who is the poet father. He has reached the prime of his age, and even he works hard for his livelihood. And when he travels back home from his work, he is not welcomed warmly by his family after a hard day work. Clear? So this is the way that you will going to write the poetic appreciation of the poem. And the first point I have explained you, and it's just an example. You need to write the other six poems are there in your syllabus, student. Okay, so one I have done for you, other rest of the five you need to do on your own. If you find difficulty, you can ask. Now theme, second point is the theme. What is the theme of this poem? The poem has a theme of isolation and alienation, because I said when he returned home back from work, he feel loneliness and man's isolation from the man-made materialistic world. This is the theme of the poem. The theme of the poem is alienation and man's isolation from the man-made materialistic world. Student, it has also got the autobiographical element, because the poet talks about his father. So this poem has an autobiographical element because as the poet talk about his father. Now poetic style. Poetic style means which type of style poet has uses in the poem. Student, this poem is of two stanza. Clear? Has been written in the form of a dramatic monologue. Dramatic monologue, student, it's a type of a poetry. Okay, dramatic monologue is a type of a poetry written in a form of a speech of an individual character. Here, it's a type of a poetry, dramatic monologue, written in a form of a speech of an individual character. The form of here, poets talk about his own father, about his life, his suffering. So it's a dramatic monologue, and dramatic monologue doesn't stick to any rhyme scheme because it is written as a free verse. Father returning home, it's a free, you can say it's a poem with a free verse, with no rhyme, with no rhythm. Therefore, because it is written in a form of a dramatic monologue, and dramatic monologue is a type of a poetry written in a form of a speech about an individual character. Clear, student? So the poet uses free words in this poem. Why? Just because his thought about the senior citizen should flow freely out of his mind. Therefore, the poet uses free words in this poem. Okay? Next, fourth point, the language and poetic device used in the poem. What kind of language poet has used in this poem? What kind of poetic devices what kind of poetic devices used in this poem. Okay, so here poetic devices, student, that means figures of speech. We, you know, in poetry, figures of speech used for the poem, you can say, just for the poetry here, for poetic effect. Okay, so you need to remember which kind of a language poet has used, which poetic devices poet has used. Okay, so here the poem is written in a very simple language, in a narrative style. Here the poet is narrating, you can say, the suffering, you can say the suffering of a blind man, okay, his own aged father. So this poem is written in a simple language, in narrative style, where the poet has uses various figures of speech. Which figures of speech is being used in this poem? That is transfer appetite, simile, alliteration, onomatopoeia, synecdoche, repetition, and metaphor. Okay, but the prominent figure of speech which is used in this poem is, I have already highlighted here in the bold form, simile, alliteration, onomatopoeia. This is the prominent figure of speech which is used in this poem. So you need to remember, prominent is simile, SAO. Try to remember with a alphabet pattern, SAO, that means simile, alliteration, onomatopoeia. Okay, an example of simile, you can write two or one example from the poetry, any figure of speech which is prominent in the poem. So I have highlighted here simile. An example of simile from the poem is the line, this line, now I can see him getting off the train like a word drop from a, here, student, indirect comparison is being done, and here we come to know with a word like, indicate that it's a simile. Why poet has used simile? Just to show people that how people have become indifferent with the existence of the other, existence of other. Therefore, as he compared his father, as his father getting off from the train with the word drop from a long sentence. Okay, so this is an example of simile from the poem. The poet has drawn a pen picture of his aged father. What kind of a picture here? A pen picture, that everything about the hectic schedule, hectic routine, and he also talk about the pathetic condition, a worse condition by the use of many descriptive words. Poet has used many descriptive words in order to highlight, you can say, in order to highlight the pathetic condition as well as the hectic routine of his aged father. So this kind of a you can say language and poetic device which is used in this poem. So you try to take another example of any poem and try to write it on your own, student. This is just an example which I have done for your convenient. Okay, next point, special features. Every poem has some special features in it. In this poem, the poet has used symbolism and imagery. The poem is full of symbols, symbolic. There is symbolism as well as imagery, which symbolizing the various theme of the poem. The theme of the poem was, I have already highlighted, alienation and man-made materialistic, you can say, isolation from the man-made materialistic world. Okay, so here imagery, the use of imagery is evident in the poem. How you have to give proof that what kind of an imagery poet has used in the poem. So here the poet is sketching the image of his father as an old man by the word, descriptive word, eyes dim by age, grave platform, fade homeward, that means everything is blur. I also describing his father appearance. His father appearance means his shirts and pants are soggy. Soggy means wet. Black raincoat that was stained with mud. Chappals are sticky with mud. So the strong use of imagery makes the poem, student, quite appealing. Message, any message, any moral of the poem. What message this poem gives, student? His message, the poet message to the young generation, to the youth, that we must take care of the senior citizen as they need our attention to come out of their insecurity. because student loneliness is the biggest problem prevail in the, you can say, in the life of a senior citizen. Loneliness is the biggest problem prevail in the life of a senior citizen. So here try to help them to overcome with the problem of loneliness, because they need our attention to come out of their insecurity. So this message the poet gives to the young generation. Now moral of the poem. Moral in the poem is, we should try to overpass the gap between old generation and young generation and protect the elderly people. My opinion about this poem, student, that I like the poem, highly important in today's time. In a simple way, this poem highlighted the suffering and emotion of the elderly people, which is an eye-opener to the reader. So student, this is the proper way of writing a poetic appreciation of the poem. So try to take any poem, an example of any poem, try to solve it. And this is an example. And always remember, you need to highlight the point and you need to write point wise. Okay, so it will be convenient for the examiner also to assess your paper, and when you highlighted it, you will going to get good marks. Okay, so thank you so much. See you in the next.